for more on this and how the auto industry is faring amid market turmoil due to the coronavirus. We are joined by Lauren Fix, the car coach. Lauren, it is a pleasure to have you. Wish it was under better circumstances. Now, this 79% decline is massive. And really, sales in China had already fallen for 20 straight months. Now, do you really expect sales to pick up in the coming months as the world is still very concerned about this virus?
Right. Well, thank you, Brent. And I think one of the biggest things is that people are back to work in China. So they're not on all shifts right now. Most are on one and two shifts. The third shift's supposed to be coming online hopefully next week. That means people are starting to make money again, and they have to make up for that loss while they were sitting at home, whether they got paid or not, because obviously that kind of gives you uncomfortableness about spending money in your economy. Once people start getting more open to spending money again, I think the car sales will pick up a bit. It is rock bottom worst we've ever had in China, with only 310,000 vehicles sold in the month of February. So once people start purchasing vehicles again, I think the total for the year of 2020 is going to be up by about a million, which is pretty equivalent to what we're going to see here in the U.S.
Factories in the epicenter of the outbreak in China, like you mentioned, are just starting to reopen, but obviously some, most are not operating at full capacity. Now manufacturers throughout the world rely on China for parts. This has been mostly in the recent decade. How much has this situation affected the supply chain for other automakers?
Well, Sarah, you're right. I mean, it is a huge impact on all auto manufacturers, whether it's aftermarket parts and components. So you're looking at a company like Brembo, who makes brakes for a lot of the vehicles that are out there. If they're missing a seal or a piston and they have the castings, they still can't build these components. So the impact is huge. You may not see it right away. So you're seeing manufacturers shutting down production because they don't have parts. But once they get up and started, they still got to get those parts from the factory to the manufacturing facility. That could be a 6 to 8 week leeway. And with that gap of time, that's where I think you're going to see an impact of slow moving sales. And it's going to take a while for all these parts and components to get back up to speed.
Let me ask you this. I know that a lot of closures are still around the Wuhan area, which is a huge industry where the car manufacturers are. How is right. that going to affect it as well? And is that going to further then delay these the delivery of these parts?
Right, you're right. It is going to further delay things. They call it the Rock Candy Mountain because literally they make everything in the Wuhan district. And because of that fact, if you're looking for an interface for your car, as I've said in the past, you cannot sell a vehicle that's only built with 99% of the parts. So that's going to be a delay where they've got production lines stopped. I know they've already got Lamborghini stopped production. Mm-hmm. I know that Toyota is stopping production on certain product lines. I know other companies are as well. And they're doing this because if you don't have all the parts and components, you're going to need another supplier. And I think what it's going to do is potentially cause other countries to be able to pick up some of those sales as a backup supplier, so this doesn't ever happen again.
Right.
And now, Lauren, I want to ask kind of a broad question here, because we're talking about that decline sure. in China, and you said it, you know, that 1 million, the sales being down 1 million sales is going to be right aligned with the rest of the world. But how are sales doing throughout the rest of the world as we deal with this pandemic?
Well, it depends on the country. I mean, obviously, Italy is shut down right now. Literally, they've closed every shop, every store, so nothing's being produced. So if you're building Fiats or Lamborghinis or Ducati motorcycles, which they build in Bologna, nothing's being sold and no one's got money because they're all sitting at home. If you work retail or you wait tables, you don't have any cash flow. If you work in a place that you can work from home, it's a different story. So I think the impact on a global basis is going to be quite dramatic. And we're going to see that impact not just in automotive, but in other categories such as tech as well,
right.
because all of this, again, is connected.
I mean, so many sectors are being affected, like the tech world is another major one. But I want to end on this. A lot of cancellations on a lot of shows, a lot of conferences around the world. Now, the auto show in Geneva being canceled due to the coronavirus this week, it was announced right. that the New York Auto Show would also then be postponed. How important right. are these events for the industry?
Oh, it's huge. And actually, it's impacting me as well. Typically, I'm at all the trade shows on a global basis. We go out and we drive cars. We talk to executives. We get the opportunity of the first person in the vehicle so that we can report on it so that your station and other stations can get this information. But if we don't have any of that, and manufacturers are telling everyone to work from home, and right. these trade shows are shut down, and they cleared our schedule, it's really going to be an impact. Because if there's no information going out, people aren't going to be buying cars.
Lauren Fix, the car coach, thank you for your expert analysis. We'll have you back really soon.
Thank you.